Welcome all to Off the Cuff with Namrita, and today I'm at the Sala Festival 2024, and it's my delight and pleasure to have Suvir Saran here with me. Suvir Saran is a Michelin star chef, cook, cookbook author, educator, as well as a farmer who specializes in bringing Indian cooking to the American kitchen. Viewing the kitchen as both a culinary and spiritual haven and an extension of his heart and soul, New Delhi-born top chef Master Suvir Saran has nurtured a lifelong passion for the traditional flavors of Indian cooking. So welcome, Suvir.
Thank you, Namrata.
Suvir, I saw your TED talk and you were talking about self-identity. So if I start with the question, it's going to be a long answer, but in a nutshell. So who is Suvir Saran?
You know, if I knew, mm-hmm. I would be dead. I think we spend a lifetime discovering who we are. Mm-hmm. And when we live mindfully, when we make unfettered mistakes, but with good intention, mm-hmm. we don't know where we are headed, but we have a hunger, desire, plan that not always works out. Mm-hmm. So I think I've lived my life accepting life that comes my way. Not with plans that others have given me. I don't know why I'm so silly and lost. But I never take what's easy. I always chase what life gives me as an opportunity to do something that will fulfill my soul. Most often they're very difficult things to achieve. But the journey is delightful because I'm doing things that make me happy. So Suvir abhi Suvir hai nahi. Main rang birangi titli hu. I'm a conundrum. I'm a person living with terrible pain. I'm a author, I'm a writer, I'm a today one of India's columnists who gets 1200 words in the newspaper every other week, which is a lot for any newspaper. And I'd never written till around 5 or 6 years ago. So, you know, when we join hands with life, rather than live in opposition to life, we become richer, better, fuller, and more fulfilling versions of ourselves. And my journey continues. I think what I may be tomorrow, I don't know, because I want to be something new. Every 4 or 5 years, I learn a new craft, a skill. I become a better version of Suvir. I make mistakes, I learn from them. Some mistakes I can't erase, but from the pain of those mistakes, I hope not to repeat others of that type. And they also give me strength to be daring enough to do things which will be more challenging. But the pain past, the suffering past has taught me to push forward, spring forward and embrace the unknown and become new versions of Suvir with every passing day. So, main kaun hu mujhe ki nahi pata, main aap apni talash mein hu. Mera koi rehnuma nahi hai. Wo kya dikhayenge raah mujhko jinhe khud apna pata nahi hai. But I truly believe that I don't know who I am. There's no GPS location rounding me. Wherever I put my head at night is the place I call home. Home is a puzzle. It can be across the world, in a hotel room or in an aeroplane. For me, home is that's the place. Home is 4 walls I don't consider home. Where I rest my head is home. And nobody else can tell me what to be because they're as lost as me. So neither Pandit nor Mullah nor Ragi nor Rabbi, because I think they're all human. We're all broken bits and bobs and we collect ourselves and do our best. And as long as we do our best with good intentions, the mistakes are forgiven from ourselves and from the divine.
What a lovely answer. And you are a courageous man, I'll say. It's not easy to live the way you are living. And you don't like the comfort zones, I'll say. So, you know, you always challenge that.
Bahut boring hota. Comfort to me is overrated. Because there's comfort mein aapko kya mil raha hai? You're shackled. You're boxed. You're contained. You're controlled. You're measured. You are judged, you are being graded. When you live life your own way, with your identity, with your brain, your heart and your soul coming together to make you who you are, nobody else knows what you should be. But that happiness, joy, fulfillment that you get is guttural. That is you. Otherwise, we're all sheep, just doing what other people have prescribed for us.
But I think most people feel comfortable when they know, you know, the environment is controlled. Conditioned.
They've been conditioned.
Yes.
And we are afraid. And I don't know why. Because why are we giving another human that? Why are we giving another human a school, a college, a job, a profession, the ability to change who we are?
Very true. I know. That says it all. But what attracted you to cooking?
So from a young age, from age 4 or 5, I've been cooking in the kitchen at our home in Delhi. Bandaji, our Brahmin chef, used to cook for us. And my mother would cook in the afternoon when he went to bed. Cakes and pastries and all kinds of other foods.
Yeah.
I found a place where creativity was thriving. Where I, a young boy who was gay but didn't have the word gay, in my brain I knew I was wrong. I was aberration. I was to be killed, to be thinking as I did. The kitchen gave me a place of safe cocoon and comfort and inspiration, and I just felt safe there. So I'm cooking from the age of 5, and I found in food a friend, and I found by feeding others, their smiles and their guttural joy taught me, okay, I'm not that wrong. I can do something to make another person's life easier and better and happier.
Like you're saying, it was like a spiritual haven for it you, was, where you found comfort.
I wasn't afraid in the kitchen. I wasn't being judged. I wasn't being condemned. I wasn't being hated. I wasn't being called faggot. I wasn't being... I was me. I was giving people what they enjoyed. I was part of a meal that people say, oh my God, Devi Prasad, Panditji, tumne kya banaya hai? Bhaiya ne bhi madad kari. So I was part of something bigger than myself.
Bigger than yourself. Was it that you were looking for validation on certain sorts? Or
no, but I felt there was joy in seeing somebody smile. That if my labor could give somebody coming tired or from a divorce or a hospital and sitting at the table, eating a bite and think, oh my God, ye kya badhiya cheez hai. I was part of something bigger than us humans.
Absolutely.
And that just gave, I've done something good today. I've been part of something good.
Jaise humari nani dadi ne humko bataya hai ki pyaase ko pani pilao, chahe jo bhi aaye. So that gives that spiritual.
And wo satsangati ho jati na.
Bilkul, community. Absolutely. And now, you know, you are a Michelin star here. I think your restaurant, Devi, got this.
First Indian restaurant in America.
Yeah, that's amazing. Congratulations on that.
No, real planet had nothing to do with it. We made mistakes. People love them.
Mistakes mein Michelin star. But you're being humble here. But you did bring a different kind of Indian food, you know, to the Americans here. Farm fresh, homemade, like you were saying. Because hum gourmet ki baat karte hain, toh we start to think about creams and all those thick gravies. So
there's nothing gourmet about butter chicken, dal makhni, tandoori chicken, paneer makhni, jaini pizza, chiji pav bhaji. These are disgusting foods. But when you go to an Indian home from one region to the other, one state to the other, every 50 kilometers, Indian food takes on a new regional makeup. It takes on a communal makeup. It takes a religious bent. It takes a tyohar ka celebration. Eidi ki sheer khurma. The riches of India are so magnificent. The khana ka khazana is so unmatched anywhere in the world. But we Indians are ashamed of our own food. We are creating these terrible foods that are heart attacks, diabetes, bad cholesterol, all in every bite. But we've gotten ourselves numb with it. Jab hum aise behuda khana kha rahe hain, duniya kyun hamare khane ko acha kahegi? To hamesha Indian food every few years is the next best thing. But it's never become the best thing. Sushi aa gayi, Thai aa gaya, Vietnamese aa gaya, Malaysian aa gaya, Korean aa gaya, India abhi nahi aaya. Kyunki hamara khana hai nahi hamara khana. Butter chicken kaise khana ban gaya? Wo to abhi 1940s mein dish bani. Us dish mein ganda sa ingredients hai. Kaun aise mindless khana khata hai? But our dal sabzi, sukhi sabzis, our pasindas, our stuffed sabzis, our whole grain ki rotis and parathas and chilas, these were invented through history. Through millennia, with mindfulness, with a thought, honesty. And those are our foods, and that's what I brought today.
Yeah, wow. wonderful, you know, to hear that. And I think America is going the Indian way, jo pehle hota tha.
Not all, but when we eat in fine restaurants, I agree. America has understood the mistakes.
Absolutely.
When America is the world's fattest nation.
Yeah,
has
obesity.
Terrible obesity.
Yes.
They've understood what they did wrong. They're not correcting it in any rush.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I am the only chef on the board of Harvard Medical School, not because I'm a good looking man, but because I bring the Indian arsenal of home cooking to the people at this university who are looking at public health with a more widespread hunger for bringing health and wellness with every bite. India gives that in its old recipes,
yeah, it
not
does.
The food of today.
Yeah, yeah.
Our restaurant food is terrible.
Yeah, I've grown up in the, you know, 60s and 70s in a small town in Shimla, and we would have seasonal food. Wahan bahar se
aapki jo chutneyan
exactly
hoti hai, my god, sab draw banti, you see, like pestos.
Exactly.
And hum log jab Italy jaate hain to
roti ke
pesto kha rahe hain, kha rahe hain to Himachal mein to dal ko bhi grind karke usko powder bana ke phir gila karke,
yeah,
kya mazedar, they created texture hai, all of it there,
and we were
no process, no, you were better.
Better.
You didn't have to go to a doctor to get your arteries cleaned up.
Very true, very true, very true. And so we're talking about your life now. You know, you said somewhere pain doesn't have a GPS, and you know, I read on you've had some difficult times in your life, health wise and otherwise. So how did you rise like a phoenix? What gives you the strength to come back?
I think my friends, my family, okay, my mother, my brother, my sister, my aunts, uncles, okay, relatives, my music teacher, my staff at my restaurants,
okay,
my students I've trained and educated, they all told me, Chef, believe in yourself, there's a tomorrow there.
Okay.
And so when I was seeing death, they weren't seeing death in me.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that confidence that they had in me and my ability to survive the worst challenges made me come out of a shock. I was allowing myself to die because I didn't want to be blind. I didn't want to have bad memory. I didn't want to be living in pain. So I stopped eating, stopped being part of the world.
Okay.
These people just all corralled around me and created a full positive environment where Suvir became their focus. Suvir's healing became their focus. And Suvir's idiocies, Suvir's off the path personality, his passion for singing, his skills, they took them to another level. They taught me, oh, you write so well, column likho, column ban gaya, column sab Indian Express pe aa gaya. So Shashi Tharoor wrote a foreword to my book.
Oh, nice.
So, you know, life happened. So I give all credit to life, love, laughter that friends and relatives filled my life.
So I think to everybody, community matters. You know, America
totally.
Is, yeah, definitely. We come from a collective society. You know, that is India. And America is a kind of individualistic society where we feel so much of isolation sometimes. And, you know, we feel like a misfit here and also there.
Well, I am the first. I'm the first generation here.
Huh.
I've always been the other.
हिंदुस्तान में वो मैं
मैं गे हूँ तो मैं छक्का हूँ, ये हूँ वो हूँ, यहाँ पे मैं अरब टेररिस्ट, एफिंग हिंदू, आइडोलेट्रस, सब कुछ अदर था. तो आई डोंट थिंक अमेरिका वगैरह की बात है. यहाँ पे इन अमेरिका देयर इज अ कम्युनिटी इन लिंडा लोमा कैलिफोर्निया ऑफ सेवंथ डे एडवेंटिस्ट. दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ क्रिश्चियनिटी, इट्स एन ऑफशूट ऑफ क्रिश्चियनिटी. व्हाट दे डू, दे ईट टुगेदर एज अ कम्युनिटी. दे eat their meals together. They cook together. They chat as a community. You know what they're doing? What we called it in Sanskrit? Satsangati. You're healing together. You're giving each other that balm. That when you're broken, you're saying, I'm here with you. They don't have as much rape and robbery and theft and crime in their community. They live 8 to 10 years longer than any other American.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So they are like, they are mirroring the lives of the blue zones of the world.
Yes.
Ikaria, Okinawa,
Japan.
Hunza Valley.
Yes.
So in America, it's possible. But these people have understood the value of eating together, staying together, policing one another, giving good habits, killing bad habits from each other. So humans, we are a social being. The sooner we realize that we are not perfect, we are not meant to be perfect. That perfection that we are driving, whether it's Indian or American, is killing us. When we know, aap bhi toote ho, main bhi toota ho, be each other's band-aids and be there for one another. Nobody is any better or worse. We are all equal.
See, you're making me emotional here, you know, such strong words. have to say. क्या बोलना था मैंने, आई थिंक यू नो वी ऑल्सो लुक एट ईच अदर विद फियर, लाइक वी आर द अदर, बट वेन वी डोंट नो द अदर पर्सन एंड वी जस्ट फियर ऑल्सो काइंड ऑफ ट्रिगर्स दैट ओके ओ ही और शी डजंट लुक लाइक मी यू नो समथिंग टू फियर अबाउट.
वेरी बिग थिंग यू सेड. आई वाज टॉट एट अ यंग एज टू नॉट फियर एनीबडी.
ओके.
माय मदर टॉट मी दैट द वर्ल्ड इज एन एको चेंबर. My mother, I don't know where she picked up for me from the Bible, because she wasn't really well versed in Hindi literature. But when I came of age, my mother's biblical education mirrored Kabir's education. Kabir कहते हैं कि बोए पेड़ बबूल का आम कहाँ से होए? That when you're sowing the seeds of a thistle plant, how do you expect mangoes to be given to you in harvest? तो जब आप दूसरे को डरावना समझते हो आप किसी के डरावने हो. जब आप उसको सुंदर समझते हो आपको कोई सुंदर समझता है. जब आप कहते हो वो चोरी करेगा कोई कहेगा आप चोरी करोगे. तो मेरे माँ बाप ने, माई पेरेंट्स टॉट अस एट अ यंग एज दैट द वर्ल्ड इज अ ब्यूटिफुल प्लेस, पीपल कम, इनोसेंस इज आवर आइडेंटिटी, protect one another, be there for one another, be collegiate, be satsangati, be kind, be generous, be gracious, be forgiving, because you expect all of that in return. So what you, the Bible calls it the golden rule, do unto others as you want done to you. So when you are scared, you are scared because you are doing something wrong yourself. When you are afraid, you are afraid because you are sharing that fear. Koi aur nahi kar raha. Hamari divya shackled by our own failure, our own smallness, our own inadequacy of being patient and kind and generous and gracious, because we are lazy. The day we start giving more of ourselves, others will give to us.
Very true. And it's also about exposure.
And it's not a khata. Life is not an Excel spreadsheet. I give this, I don't. No, you do what makes you happy.
Absolutely.
And set it forth in the world. And let others do what makes them happy. The world is an echo chamber. What goes around comes around. If you put good, good comes to you.
Very true. Very true. Very well said. And, you know, like you're saying, food for me also and for most of the people is not just flavor. It's an experience. It's nostalgia. It's memories. And it's a way of connecting with strangers. Like
and it's so sitting at the table having conversations. It's healing one another.
Okay.
You're giving therapy. You're giving affirmation. You're giving celebrations. You're giving comfort. You are healing. You're providing a platform for people to address issues that matter. So the table is not just about food. It's about people coming together and validating one another's lives. Without fusing them into one another. Melting pot nahi hai zindagi mein. Life is a mosaic. Every piece is relevant. No human being should be covered, hidden, diluted into another. We allow that. You know that word, behuda word, melting pot. No culture should be a melting pot. We are mosaic. Bikhre bikhre tare hai hum, lekin jhilmil ek hai. Hum sab Bharatiya, and you can make it global. And dusri baat, you know, when we talk of mosaics and melting pot, hum log जुड़े होते हैं तो हम लोग ज्यादा आगे बढ़ते हैं, बिकॉज व्हेन वी आर व्हेन वी लिव विदाउट फियर वी क्रिएट बेटर.
वेरी ट्रू. सो वेल सेड वंस अगेन. एंड लाइक यू हैव रिटन सो मेनी बुक्स इन द लास्ट बुक इज नेम्ड आई थिंक इंस्टामैटिक. सो नाउ यू नो विद सोशल मीडिया कमिंग इनटू प्ले, पहले तो हम नानी दादी की देखते थे रेसिपीज, रेसिपी बुक्स होती थी या मैगजीन्स होती थी. अब इंस्टा रील्स शुरू हो गई हैं, दे आर मेकिंग फूड लुक you know something else. What do you have to say about the social
media? Instagram is not the issue again.
Okay.
Humans are breaking Instagram.
Okay.
Instagram is an amazing platform.
Okay.
When used correctly, there's nothing that matches it. We are connecting the world at so many levels. We are giving inspiration to people that we couldn't have given just through libraries or music, DVDs and CDs. Instagram is immediate connection. But when commodity boards, small ideas, bald, rabid capitalism that doesn't care about humanity, when these are the forces taking people to Insta moments shared on Instagram, it's not Instagram's fault. It's the humans. We are to blame. We are all pointing, we are always blaming something. We have to reflect, what have I done today to make my life better? Did I put on an Instagram a reel that mattered? रेसिपीज में बेहुदा हूँ. वॉन्ट टू ईट दैट क्रैप. दे लुक प्रिटी बट कुछ भी.
बाथरूम
ब्रेक टू प्रिटी खाना. आई डोंट नीड प्रिटी खाना. आई नीड ब्यूटिफुल खाना दैट गिव्स कम्फर्ट. इट कुड बी अ सिंपल दाल चावल इज रनी अगली लुकिंग. My editor, Pam Krause, was the editor to Martha Stewart, Aina Garten, Rachel Ray, Mario Batali, Ming Sai, and me. That woman said to me that Mario and your food looks like kaka. Kaka is a word for poop. Oh. And she said, but tastes like heaven.
Okay.
So it didn't matter.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Food should taste good, be good for your body, inspire delicious conversations, give you comforting sleep without heartburn. No need to take Milanta. जब आप वो खाना बनाओगे आपका खाना गलत भी लगे doesn't matter. क्योंकि आपने जो दिया है वो heart, mind and body and soul सबको heal कर रहा.
मैं तो यही कहूंगी after talking to Suveer that you know whenever you eating or you taking a break you know from your busy schedule in the Silicon Valley or elsewhere, just give it time. Even if you're eating alone, थोड़ा आराम से खाएं, सोच के खाएं, सांस लेके खाएं. Because I've seen in my family also gulping.
नहीं नहीं. At two, vacuum cleaner नहीं
है. Vacuum नहीं है.
आप इंसान हैं. खाना इंसानियत का सबसे बड़ा एक जरिया है इंसान बनने का. तो खाने पे time दें. Exercise less. Exercise sculpts your body. Food cleanses your mind, feeds your soul. And connects you sustainably for tomorrow. When you eat in a rush, when you eat crap, you are sitting in front of a doctor more often than you deserve to. People in France and Greece and the Mediterranean where they eat beautiful food that was still cooked like 200 years ago aren't going to doctors as much as we do. So put your head in the right place. Ayurveda ki nation mein aaj hum log behuda khana khate. To aap dimag se khana banaye, dimag ko khol kar jaanch kare kya kha rahe hain, and mil jhul ke ek saath khaye. टाइम के साथ इत्मीनान के साथ एक डेढ़ घंटा स्पेंड एट द टेबल. वन एंड हाफ आवर्स इज नॉट टू मच एट द टेबल. बिकॉज़ यू आर नॉट जस्ट ईटिंग, यू आर क्लेंसिंग योर सोल, यू आर हैविंग कैथारसिस एंड यू आर बिल्डिंग अ फ्यूचर फॉर यू एंड योर फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली एंड योर किड्स एंड टुमारो.
वेल सेड. एंड जस्ट आई नो लंबा हो गया बट एक चीज मेरे जो जहन में आई है कि वो पिल कल्चर बहुत चढ़ गया है. The food in a pill, you know, you don't have to have a regular food.
वो खाना नहीं है. देखिए आजकल protein powder,
ये सब turmeric latte, turmeric
latte, घी में coffee. Are you mad? My mother says it beautifully. She said, influenza is not killing. No, my mother says influenza is not killing humanity. Affluenza is.
Oh.
We've gotten rich, but we are brain dead. पहले जमाने में घी महंगा था तो अब कम खाते थे.
हाँ.
दो जो when a fat congeals at room temperature. Your artery, your heart chamber is cooler than your body.
Cooler,
so it's like cement in your arteries. Think.
Wow.
There's nothing right about ghee or coconut fat or beef tallow or any of these saturated fats and terrible fats that we've, like Crisco, they're terrible for you. They're at room temperature, they're solid. They're doing the same thing in your arteries. So thora indulgence is okay. Everything in moderation, including moderation.
Okay.
If a little bit of ghee is making you eat fibrous dal with pleasure,
then
take
fine,
it.
Huh?
That two drops don't do anything wrong. But when you're cooking the chapati in ghee and frying pakoras in ghee and then putting two chamach of ghee into your katori afterwards, mummy ne chhoka dala do chamach dal rahe, that is, you're asking for trouble. No wonder we are now rivaling America in obesity and all kinds of illness.
Heart disease and diabetes and everything, yeah. So I think everything in moderation and
including moderates.
Absolutely, Samir. I'm so glad that you could give
Thank
me this time.
Thank you for making time for me.
Yeah. मैं तो यही कहूँगी जो खुद को ढूँढने निकला था शायद उसे सारी कायनात खुद में मिल गई. So I think he's a world in himself. I think
we all are.
Yeah.
And आप अपने world को ढूँढिए. आप उस world में जब जुड़ जाएंगे जिंदगी आपकी आपको समझ आ जाएगी. जिंदगी is We are nothing. The Gita, kya kehte hai? Advesta sarva bhutanam, maitrah karuna evacha. That in the entire planet, there's no other. Advait. We are all one.
All one.
Advesta sarva bhutanam, in the entire planet, maitrah karuna evacha. With love and friendship and compassion for all. Nirmamo nirahankara, without moho, without ego. Nirmamo nirahankara, samad dukha sukhakshami. In good and bad times, remain equipoised. That Krishna tells Arjuna is his favorite bhakt. Not a pujari, not a aarti karne wala, not a fast rakhne wala. but in their mind. You have to be a karmachari. Do good actions, not puja part. And when you live that way, you are living the Vedantic way of being one with the planet and one with yourself.
Yeah. I read somewhere like, you know, your religion starts after you stop praying. You know, you do.
Prayer is a ritual.
So what you do after
prayer is
there. Thank you once again. Thank you for coming on Off the Cuff. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.
Shosha is a creative Indian restaurant located in the heart of Silicon Valley. Shosha is a woman-owned business that serves traditional Indian flavors assimilated with molecular gastronomy techniques. The best Indian bar with happy hours in the Bay Area serves handcrafted drinks inspired by flavors from India with modern craft cocktails that are presented in unique ways. Shosha is a modern take on traditional Indian cuisine. We specialize in corporate luncheon, anniversary celebrations, birthday parties, and catering. Do check us out for a memorable modern Indian dining experience. Shosha is located at 141 South Murphy Avenue in Sunnyvale, California.